vast space, the final frontier. If you look up into a cloudless night, you'll see the sky full of galaxies, stars, moons, and Ploonets. Wait, what? Ploonets? Exactly! That's not a slip of the tongue. I'm a professional. My tongue doesn't slip. I do mean brand new space objects that scientists have been hunting with fervor recently. Intriguing name aside, these objects are, in fact, runaway moons with an equally intriguing nature. Well, admittedly, at first, astronomers suggested naming these space objects something a bit different, but probably even cuter – moon moons. Sounds more like a cream-filled cupcake or something, huh? This name was supposed to reflect the very idea of the unusual objects – moons that might be orbiting other moons in faraway solar systems. But later, not only was the original name changed to Ploonets, but scientists also revised the very idea of these celestial bodies. That's why now a Ploonet starts as a moon that orbits a giant planet, which in turn orbits a hot star. Ooh, that's a hot star. And then this moon just runs away from its motherland to become a Ploonet. For example, let's take Jupiter, a gas giant of our solar system. Please, somebody take Jupiter. If one day one of its 79 moons abandons the planet, it'll become a satellite of our sun. Hence the name planet, its new position, plus moon, what it used to be, gives us a Ploonet. Some linguistic addition, if you will. But today, Ploonets are in danger. Well, what isn't? The problem is that these space bodies are like unicorns. Everyone talks about them, but nobody's ever seen one. And that's why astronomers from Earth are hunting Ploonets, trying to prove they exist. It started in 2018, when scientists discover something that didn't fit into the previously accepted theory. Now, let me tell you a bit more about this theory. For the past couple of decades, Earthlings, that's us, have located more than 4,000 exoplanets, which are any planets hanging around somewhere in space outside our solar system. You might think that with exoplanets being so numerous, there had to exist countless exomoons, satellites orbiting these planets. But interestingly, they've been super elusive, probably due to their smaller size. And maybe they're shy. Fast forward to 2018. It seemed like scientists found one. The thing was ginormous and was named Neptmoon. Isn't that cute? Because of its size was close to that of Neptune. By the way, what kind of tunes do they play on Neptune? Probably something out of this world, huh? Wow, what did I have for lunch? Anyway, this Neptmoon thing was orbiting a monstrous gas planet approximately 8,000 light-years away from Earth. Thus, the existence of exomoons was confirmed. Case solved. Everyone happy. But not for long. The most recent study has turned everything upside down. And guess what? The change fell out of your pocket? No. The discovered exomoon might not be a moon at all. Most astronomers have agreed with the conclusion that it might be something fundamentally different. And that's how they've come to this current conclusion. First, a team of scientists developed several computer models to see how a potential exomoon would behave while circling a hot Jupiter. Oh, by saying hot Jupiter, I don't mean the actual planet in the solar system that's known by this name. Nope, a hot Jupiter is what they call any gas giant outside the solar system, orbiting close to its star. Well, interestingly, astronomers doubt that such hot Jupiters are born anywhere near their stars. It's more likely that these gas exoplanets appear on much further orbits and then migrate toward the sun. So now, imagine a moon circling a monstrous gas exoplanet that, in turn, circles the star. It's clear that this moon is under double pressure, both from its host planet's gravitational force and the one from the star they both move around. That's why, one day, when the planet moves a bit closer to the star, the moon decides it's had enough. Just kidding. It's all about physics, not the moon's decisions. The thing is that the closer the exoplanet gets to the star, the stronger the gravitational pull of the star is. And suddenly, this pull may become so strong that it'll literally push the moon away from its host planet and out of its orbit. Ta-da! Inevitably, during this process, the exomoon loses some of its mass, but what remains starts to circle the star itself. Welcome, dear new Ploonet. Scientists are sure that as soon as a Ploonet begins to orbit the host star, you won't be able to distinguish it from a real planet. That's why Ploonets might actually be a widespread space phenomenon, but Earth's astronomers just don't realize it, thinking that they're planets. And one more thing. If Ploonets really exist, it can't explain why it's so hard to locate exomoons. They just get ejected from their orbits and travel on their own as a new type of celestial body. In this case, they may become full-fledged planets, Ploonets with their own eccentric orbits and a history of being moons. Or they can turn into planetary embryos which are moving around the star, biding their time. Yo, what's up? But however cute and lovely Ploonets are, they are doomed, and not because the Earth scientists are hunting them. Computer simulators show that 6% of Ploonets get munched by their stars, like a celestial snack food. More than 44% of them eventually crash into their own host planets. How rude. 2% are pushed so hard that they leave their planetary system and are bound to float forever through interstellar space. The rest of the Ploonets, about 48%, are supposed to survive. But since astronomers aren't 100% sure yet if Ploonets exist at all, we don't know about it in all certainty. And do you want to know the saddest news?
No. Sorry, but I just have to tell you.
You've probably heard that our planet's own moon is slowly but steadily moving away from Earth with every passing year. It makes scientists believe that in some 5 billion years, our moon may also end up as a Ploonet.
Just how heartbreaking is that?
Not much really, since none of us will be around then, so who cares? You see, neither our planet nor the satellite has any chances to survive anyway. By that time, the sun will have already expanded, turning into a raging red giant with a diameter of about the size of the Earth's orbit and destroying everything around, including my iPhone. Dagnabbit! But let's get back to much more cheerful stuff. If Ploonets do exist, they might explain the unsolved mystery of the Tabby star. Approximately 50% larger than our sun and way hotter, this star is located around 1,000 light-years away from the solar system. But what's been baffling astronomers for years is the star's eerie ability to dim for several days or even weeks at a time. Due to its nature, the star should always be bright. That's why such light fluctuations just don't make any sense. What's more, the star has been growing fainter and fainter over the past century. But Ploonets could be the answer to the mystery. Researchers agree that it looks as if something's blocking the Tabby star. And if this something is a mass of planets, there must be more than 50 of them. So what if they aren't planets, but a bunch of Ploonets, aligned and circling the star? Astronomers admit that they could theoretically create the flickering effect we see. Another puzzling space phenomenon Ploonets could help us with is a star called KIC-12557548. Oh, these exciting poetic star names. I'll call it Stanley instead. When scientists were examining this star, they noticed some dimming in its brightness. On the one hand, it's normal for a star to look not so bright once a month or so. It means that a planet passes in front of it and blocks the same amount of light every time. But in the case with the star, Stanley instead, scientists figured out that its light drops in intensity every 15 hours, and by different degrees at that. What gives? Initially, to explain this phenomenon, astronomers developed the theory of a planetary duo. That's when two planets orbit each other, all the while circling the star. This way, these planets would block out a different amount of light every time they go around. However, later, everybody admitted that 15 hours is too short of a time frame for the duo to make one full trip around the star. That's why Ploonets could be the answer we're looking for. But as you remember, these cuties are still entirely theoretical, and we have to wait for astronomers to actually catch one. So, good luck to them. Now, do you believe that Ploonets exist and we'll see them one day? Let me know down in the comments. If you learned something new today, then give this video a like and share it with a friend. But hey, don't go plooning a trip to see the Ploonets just yet. We have over 2,000 cool videos for you to check out. All you have to do is pick the right or left video, click on it, and enjoy. Stay on the bright side of life.